Hey everybody, it's Stacy with Life Beautiful Design. I'm here today to show you how to use our new wonderful Miracle Paint by Amy Howard Home to paint your front door for the new front door contest, almost a glow up contest if you may. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna paint the front door with Bergeret, B-E-R-G-E-R-E blue. It's almost a haint blue color. And the reason I chose this color, let's see if you can see it here. If you look at this brick, you can notice that it's got some orange tones and some red tones to it. Up here is another piece that's a little bit more vibrant. So with that orange and that red tone, if we look at a color wheel, we're gonna notice that complementary colors are gonna be a blue-green in nature. So that's why I chose this color for the door. So let me show you our door that we're gonna be working with in our front porch area. So it needs some work. So if we look at this color wheel up against a brick, you see the orange red at the top, and we follow that down to the complementary color, which is the blue green at the bottom. You'll notice first on the door that we're going to paint is I'm removing all the hardware from the door itself. At the top, once I remove this deadbolt, you'll notice that there's a collar that's left on the door. What I did is that I went ahead and applied painter tape to this area to keep any paint from getting down into the mechanisms. I then proceeded with continuing removing the bottom hardware from the door itself. I also used the blue painter's tape on the back of the door to eliminate any brush marks or drips to the back on the color from the front, because I'm going to paint the back of the door the same color as the walls so that it blends. So I'm gonna give our paint a little shake here, and I'll explain why you really want to shake and mix this thoroughly here in a moment. Now I'm gonna get out the clean slate. Having trouble with the lid. Does anyone else have trouble with the lids, or is it just me? So anyway, you really want to make sure that your prep is really, 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 really good. Anytime you prep a piece for paint, the better the prep, the better the finish. So you want to make sure you get all the dust, the debris, all the fingerprints, anything that you can get off of it. The wonderful thing about the clean slate is that it will remove any oils, greases, or waxes that could be on that door, possibly from someone touching it, or if someone had finished it previously with a different type of finish that you were not aware of, it will make sure that that's a nice, literally clean slate for you to start on. Now we're gonna go back to that enamel paint that we talked about earlier. So I did shake it very well a few moments ago, as you saw. Now I'm actually gonna take a paint stick and I'm gonna stir it really, really, really well. You wanna make sure that that top coat that's in the paint is well incorporated, and make sure that you have a flawless coat. So I did do a little test sample on here to see how well that it covered, and using a square brush, which I thought would get into all the nooks and crannies better, I applied the paint to the door. Now this is a darker door, so I probably will have to do more than one coat of paint, and that's okay. This paint is meant to be applied in thin, even layers. It's not gonna be a one coat paint. On some surfaces, if it's really dark or really light and you're changing the complete tone of the paint itself, but it does cover remarkably well. And as you can see here, even my first coat has a significant coverage. So the brush that I'm using is actually the square brush from Amy Howard Home. And I did notice on the door that I did forget to tape off the glass at the top. So I'm doing that right here. You can remove the paint with a razor blade after you're done painting, and it's relatively easy to do. I just wanted to make as little cleanup as possible, so I went ahead and taped off the area, and then I'll use my razor blade later to make sure that this is a perfect finish. So now we're going back with our brush and applying this to the door. When I apply this paint with a brush, I notice that there aren't any streaks. It looks amazing with just application or brush. You can use a roller, and I'll use that later on in this process, which you'll see, just for time's sake. But a brush, if a brush is all you have, the brush looks amazing. This door that I have also has some texture to it. So it's almost like a faux wood grain. And so this brush actually helped me get down into that texture and allow my paint to be a lot smoother. So we're just gonna do coverage over the entire door. You'll notice on this door too that it doesn't appear that I have a direction that I'm painting, just kind of all over the place. The reason for that is that it's 90 some degrees here in Missouri and paint is drying really fast right now. So even though I'm inside, it's still hot with the hot sun coming in the door. So I've had to adapt my painting style to this. Typically, I would go into the inset panels, go around the panels, and then do the flat surfaces. However, with it drying so fast, what I'm having to do is, as I paint, if I notice an area of thickness, I go ahead and finish that out so that there isn't a uneven area. So my pattern is slightly random as I'm painting this today. You want to make sure you get all the nooks and crannies, all the corners. And this door is a arts and crafts style, so it's got lots of little insets and angles. And the square brush actually did amazing getting in all of that. There is a triangular brush that you can use, and I actually had it out, but the square brush seemed to work really well, and I didn't feel like I needed to add that. So here in a few minutes, I'll give you a nice close-up of the paint and my application. And so when you do a first coat of paint, or you do more than one coat of paint, I should say, with this new enamel Miracle Paint, you'll want to wait 2 hours for it to dry before applying another coat. It will be dry to touch in 30 minutes, but let it dry thoroughly before you add more paint. We're getting down to the area where I'm going to show you a close-up. So since we're a little bit closer, you can really see how this paint can be applied. The door that I painted here also was a synthetic door. Had a synthetic coating on it, but it is a wood door, but it has almost a faux wood grain to it, and that faux wood grain, I really felt like the brush got into those little grains and really helped the paint solidify in that area. And you can notice how I'm painting different directions. I am actually painting with the wood grain, and so if you paint with the wood grain, once again, less streaks, it will look more natural. And you'll see me continue to do that in this fashion. So here's the finished first coat of the door. You can see there's areas that still need to be covered. However, it's got great coverage for just one thin coat. So we will let this dry for 2 hours and we will come back and put a second coat. So now we're going to use that roller after the 2 hours on the door for our second coat. Like we discussed earlier, it's mainly just to save some time since I did use my brush to get on all the nooks and crannies and get in all that little faux wood grain so that it would be nice and even. I do at one point go back to the brush because I really liked the look of the brush painting over the use of the roller. To me, it just looked more natural. So you'll see me switch over to the brush here in a few minutes. Just kind of getting a nice little base coat with this roller on any flat surface that I can. And we're going to do the inside of the panels. And there's a really nice roller brush available at Amy Howard Home. It comes with a nice foam roller that will help this paint blend seamlessly. And now I've switched back over to the brush just to make sure that my coat is nice and smooth. And that we got all the little areas, mainly just as a finish on this door. Just getting all the little details. And it's also a good idea to stand back, get a look at the door, make sure there aren't any areas that look lighter than others that might need more paint to cover the underlying base layer. It's also good to go from different angles to make sure that you did not miss any areas that you can see in one direction and not another. Get the edges, because that will be exposed when you open the door, and that's why we taped off the back so we could get everything a uniform color. Now I'm just checking for any little areas that are left. Once I get all the areas touched up that I could have possibly missed, I will let this dry for another 2 hours and we'll see the finished product here in just a moment. Okay guys, so here's our before. You ready for the after? Here's our finished result. It really makes the door pop. I'm gonna show you here on the front door. We're gonna look and you can see that it looks a little bit more blue in some areas, a little more green depending on the light. Let me just show you what the finish looks like. Look at that, smooth. No brush strokes. I absolutely love it. Well, I hope you enjoyed this, and we'll talk to you soon.